Hello everyone, welcome back to Spectrum Classes. Today in this video I am going to show you a lab activity which is related to the determination of rate of reaction of ethyl acetate hydrolysis. This can also be understood like we are going to perform the kinetics of acid catalyzed hydrolysis of ethyl acetate. So in either way you can understand this. And this video is categorized into following steps. First is preparation of solutions, standardization of solutions, reaction mixture preparation, and titration of reaction mixture at different time intervals. And thereafter, I am going to perform the calculations. Right, so let's start with the lab activity in which we are going to see the preparation of solutions. I have weight 5.094 grams of NaOH to prepare 0.5 normal NaOH in 250 ml. Calculations are given over there, and now I am going to prepare 0.5 normal HCl, and for that I have taken 4.3 ml of concentrated HCl in 100 ml measuring flask. The standardization of these solutions of NaOH and HCl. So this is the HCl solution of 0.5 normal. Now we are going to titrate against the oxalic acid. So here is my 0.5 normal NaOH and this is 0.5 normal HCl solution. So I have taken 20 ml of 0.1 normal oxalic acid and I am going to titrate it against NaOH which I have prepared, right? So here you can see 0.1 normal oxalic acid and it's 20 ml I have taken here. Now I am going to add 2-3 drops of phenolphthalein indicator to this conical flask and here is the 0.1 initial reading. Now I am going to titrate. So what I think, I have prepared 0.5 normal NaOH and I have taken 20 ml of 0.1 normal oxalic acid. So the final reading is 3.8. Now against this NaOH, I am now going to titrate HCl solution which I have prepared 0.5 normal. So I have taken the initial reading as 4 ml. And similarly, I have added the phenolphthalein indicator to this conical flask and 10 ml of HCl, which I have prepared 0.5 normal. And now, and this is the final reading. So here you can see NaOH is 14 ml, so 10 ml against 10 ml. Now the reaction mixture preparation. So here I have taken 10 ml of ethyl acetate and 50 ml of 0.5 normal HCl solution and here you can see 0.5 normal HCl in measuring cylinder. So this is the beaker, empty beaker in which first I have transferred 50 ml of 0.5 normal HCl solution and now I am going to add 10 ml of ethyl acetate in another vessel. And these are capped in the water bath. This is just homogenized their temperature, right? Here you can see. So after 10-15 minutes, I am just going to add this ethyl acetate to the HCl solution. That is 50 ml of 0.5 normal HCl solution. I have added this 10 ml of ethyl acetate. And now I started the time. Now I am going to perform the titration of reaction mixtures at different time intervals. So after just after adding at time t is equal to 0, I have taken 10 ml of this reaction mixture and to this I have added some ice just to stop the reaction. So I here would recommend you just add a weighed amount of ice to the conical flask and here is the initial reading. I'm just going it fastly and now I started titrating it against 0.5 normal NaOH solution which I have filled in the burette. Now after time t is equal to 10 minutes, 10 ml of reaction mixture I have added And to this I have added the phenolphthalein indicator. After adding the phenolphthalein, we are just going to titrate it against NaOH solution. And now this is the final reading. For this, time t is equal to 10 minutes, right? This is the 17 ml. And at time t is equal to 20 minutes, again I have taken 10 ml of the reaction mixture. And here I am just going to add it in the conical flask. To this, I am going to add ice. And to this, we are going to add phenolphthalein indicator. And now I am going to titrate it. So here is the initial reading. And so here is the final reading. You can see this is 28 ml, and now we are going to titrate at t is equal to 30 minutes. So 10 ml of reaction mixture I have taken in the conical flask. To this, I am just going to add ice. Ice is we are adding just to stop the reaction or minimize the reaction rate. Right. And here is the initial reading. After adding the phenolphthalein, we are just going to titrate it against NaOH solution. So we are about to reach the end point. And here you can see the end point. And here is the final reading, you can see 38.5, right? And now we are going to have at time t is equal to infinity. So at the starting, when I have drawn t is equal to 0, 10 ml, at the same time I have taken 10 ml of the reaction mixture and in the conical flask, and I have transferred it in the conical flask, and then I have kept it on the water bath, which was previously set at 50 to 60 degrees centigrade. So here you, after 5 minutes, I've just, you can see the vapors here, right? So now I have titrated it after cooling, right? So this is time t is equal to infinity. After cooling, no need to add ice, because here at this moment reaction is almost complete, it is supposed. And now we are going to titrate it after adding the phenolphthalein indicator. And here you can see the, we are about to end point. So this is the end point, and this is the final reading. Now the observation table and calculation. So here at time t is equal to 0, we are having initial volume in the burette is 0 and the final reading is 8. So the total volume consumed is 8 minus 0, that is 8 ml. Right? Similarly, at time t is equal to 10, we are having this 8.0 is the initial reading and 17.0 is the final reading. So 17 minus 8, I get 9. For time t is equal to 20, I just get 9.9 volume consumed for NaOH. And at time t is equal to 30, this is the initial reading of the burette and this is the final reading of the burette, and total volume of NaOH consumed is 10.3 ml. And for t infinity, we are having 14 ml of NaOH consumed, right? So here the next step, how we are going to perform the calculations. So here I am just going to perform T V volume in at infinity, that is 14 ml, right? So 14 ml volume of NaOH consumed for T infinity. So here V infinity is this minus V at time t is equal to 0. So infinity minus v0, here I have written this v infinity minus v0, and this is 6 ml. 14 minus 8, I get 6 ml. Similarly, 14 minus 9, which is time t is equal to 10 minutes, I get 5 ml, right? So v infinity minus v 10. And similarly, for v infinity minus t at 20 minutes, so I get 4.1, and for time t is equal to 30, I get 3.7, that is v infinity minus volume at t 30 minutes. Here you can see, right? So I hope you will not have any confusion regarding this. So these are the values which I have found here. And here in this case, v infinity minus v naught behaves like the initial concentration of acid, right? So this is the initial concentration, and at time t is equal to other than 0, we are having this concentration at time t is equal time t, which is equal to a minus x. So I hope you understand. So here every time we are taking a, because the formula for first order kinetics is k is equal to 1 upon t ln a upon a minus x. So instead of a, I have written v infinity minus v naught, and instead of a minus x, I have written here v infinity minus vt. I hope you are acquainted with this formula now. So on calculation, we are just going to verify whether it is of first order reaction or not. So that I will tell you how we are going to verify this. So on putting all these values, so here I have in the calculation part, I have performed one of the calculation. So 1 upon t, that is t is equal to 10 minutes. Ln v infinity minus v0 is 6 ml. So here I have written 6. V infinity minus vt at time t is equal to 10 minutes is 5. So I have written 5 over here. Fine. So 6 upon 5 is equal to 1.2. So I have taken log of natural log of 1.2 and multiplied with 0.1, that is 1 upon 10. So on solving this equation, I just get 0.0182 per minutes, right? Or minutes inverse. And these values I have written over here. 0.018, similarly I have calculated for the other one, time t is equal to 20, so I have written 1 upon 20 ln 6 upon 4.1, and on solving the equation I get 0.019. similarly, for time t is equal to 30, I have written 1 upon 30 ln 6 upon 3.7, and on solving the equation I'll just get 0.016. In this manner, I get all these values here. And if, as we have seen, 0.01 every time, 0.01, 0.01. So in each case, we are getting a constant type of value, that is 0.01. So this suggests that this is the first order reaction or first order kinetics. Now I can show you this by graph in the Excel sheet. So here you can see same table here which I have shown you in the slide, and on taking the average I just get 0.018. now if I draw the graph between, this is time t and this is log of a, which is log of a concentration, right? Concentration at every time. So here at time t is equal to 10 minutes, we are having log v infinity minus vt, that is log of 5. So here on putting the value 1.6, and at 20 minutes I'll just put ln 4.1, then I'll get 1.4, and here for 30 minutes ln 3.7 and I get 1.3, and on putting all these values here in this graph, and I get a linear graph with the values y is equal to mx plus c. From here I can calculate. So the value of the slope and the intercept. So slope is 0.016, which we have calculated through this, right? By the calculation part. And here we can calculate it through the graph method, right? So in either way you can calculate. I hope you understand. So here this is the k is this from this equation as well as from the graph, and here we are getting that value of k is this much, and since for every time we are getting the similar result, so this is first order kinetics. Okay. You may have a confusion that on adding the ice, there is no change in the concentration, or will it? So let me tell you, we are going to calculate against 10 ml only. So whether is the volume change or not, it doesn't affect. I hope you understand. And if you find this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.